Very good morning students of class 8. So today we will learn regarding your chapter 16 which is named light. So before going to the topic light, you should know about what is the definition of the light. So before going to the definition, imagine you can see me, you can see this chalk, you can see this blackboard also through light. There is a light bulb. You can see this blackboard through that light or through sunlight. So I wrote, or today I will tell regarding this chapter, sources of the light and one of the most important property of the beam of the light and reflection of the light very briefly. So first of all, I am going to start from the definition of the light which I wrote. The definition of the light is, light is a form of energy which helps us to see things around us. So it's just a form of energy. Very simply definition. Second thing is, when ray of light or beam of light falls on any surface, it bounces off from that surface. It bounces off or bounces back from that surface of the object in all direction, which is called scattering of the light. Okay? So at night, we use many sources of light to see many things, because we know at night there is a dark. There is, we have to use any sources of light. We do not have any natural sources, so we have to use any sources of light, just like torch, candle, electric bulb, anything. So at night we use electric bulb, tube light, torch, candle to light up the surrounding things to see them properly. So at night we use this. So then come to the object. I made a category of object into two parts, which is, first one is luminous object and second one is non-luminous object. So according to me or according to everyone, luminous object means what? Which things, which body emit lights of its own, which emits lights of its own is called luminous object. Just like sun, star, candle, radio. You can know, if you know the sun is there in the day or star at night, candle is a man-made thing and radium is also a thing. You can see radium in any watch or any things, you can see the radium. So it's a luminous object. Second one is non-luminous object. Non-luminous object means what? It just opposite of the luminous object. Means which do not give out the light of its own. Called non-luminous. Example, moon, book, table, chalk, duster, mobile, anything. They do not have of their own light. They do not emit their own light, which is called non-luminous. Then I made a category of sources of light into four parts. First of all, two. One is natural source and another is man-made source. As we know, natural source means God. God made. And man-made source means we made the things. Natural means sun, stars are given by God. These are the natural sources of light. We can see sun in day and stars in night. Man-made means candle, torch. We made torch, we made candle, so called man-made sources of the light. Then come to second category. I made two category. One is hot sources of light and another is cold sources of light. Hot sources of light is completely sun and cold sources of light is star. Then come to one of the most important thing, incandescent body. So what is incandescent body? Incandescent body means which body, those body gives light as well as heat. Emit both light and heat, those bodies are called incandescent body. Okay, then come to the one of the most important property of the light, which is rectilinear property of the light. Rectilinear property means what? Imagine this is a room. When a beam of light enters with dark room, this is a light room, but I am telling about the dark room. If a beam of the light enters in a dark room, we can see that the beam of the light in a straight manner. Whenever the beam of the light enters